Hello, beautiful blockchain people. That's me again at CryptoSpine. This is my next cryptocurrency market overview. So, at the very beginning, I want to say that I will post this video to YouTube. And as I have noticed, and it seems that the YouTube videos, they go only to Steam blockchain. For example, this is my yesterday's video. And they don't appear on the Hive blockchain, so you can see that the video is absent, so it's not on Hive blockchain. I hope that YouTube very soon will figure out this issue, and automatically the video, once posted to YouTube, it will go to the bot blockchains, I mean to Steam blockchain and to Hive blockchain. And of course, I want to say that in the next 1 month, probably, I will continue to use both blockchains, Steam blockchain and Hive blockchain, and I will see where my friends are. If people use one of those blockchains, I will go to this blockchain. If the people use, my friends use the other blockchain, I will switch to the other blockchain. And once again, if some of the people stay on one of the blockchains and they continue to use the another one, I will continue to use both blockchains. So now let's move to the prices of the major cryptocurrencies according to the beautiful site of CoinGecko. And we see that the price of Bitcoin has dropped by 4.2%. So after the slight, or to some extent moderate, price rebound, now the price of Bitcoin is moving sideways, or it is trying to stabilize. And the same price dynamic has been followed by the rest of the major cryptocurrencies, so we see that their charts are quite similar. I want to say that today I will analyze the price chart of IOTA, a very interesting cryptocurrency. I want to say that yesterday I analyzed the price chart of Cardano. Last week I analyzed the price chart of Tron. Today I will analyze the price chart of IOTA. So this is actually the daily chart of IOTA according to the site of TradingView. But at the very beginning, I want to mention the history or the main information behind this cryptocurrency. So IOTA is an open source distributed ledger cryptocurrency and so on, and it is using directed acyclic graph technology instead of the traditional blockchain. So it uses the so-called Tangle. It is a new data structure based on direct acyclic graph and which doesn't need miners and data blocks. So why I'm outlining these specifications or main features of this cryptocurrency IOTA? Because I remember back in 2017, or actually even in 2016, when Bitcoin or the ecosystem of Bitcoin was approaching the scalability issue, and it hit the scalability issue in 2017 at the very beginning, such kind of cryptocurrencies, they used to be very interesting and attractive on paper, of course, such as IOTA, because they were a kind of possible solution to the scalability issue of Bitcoin. And IOTA implemented a different technology that I just outlined instead of this blockchain technology in order to propose or to put on the table some different solution to the scalability issue of Bitcoin. And I remember that some of the developers behind that project, they even used to work for the development of Bitcoin. Later, they started to criticize the code and even the ecosystem of Bitcoin, and they decided to launch another product or IOTA that they claim to be much better than Bitcoin. So IOTA was a kind of, in a few words, or to put it in a nutshell, IOTA was a cryptocurrency, and it is still a cryptocurrency, that used to be some kind of, let's say, proposal or a proposal of a solution to the scalability issue of Bitcoin. And such kind of projects, they attracted a lot of attention back in 2017 when Bitcoin faced the scalability issue. Of course, Bitcoin is still having this scalability issue, but the interest or the attraction of such kind of project is to some extent disappearing. So even though they are not that attractive at the moment. So once again, IOTA is one of the biggest cryptocurrencies, is measured by market cap. So it is on 25th place. That's the price charts. So now let's analyze the price chart of IOTA. So this is the daily time frame. I want to say that we see that the trading started in the second half of 2017, and IOTA was able to capture this hype as well, such as Cardano, the cryptocurrency that I analyzed yesterday, and the price of IOTA skyrocketed back in 2017. Up to the levels close to $6, $5, $6, and even on some exchanges to $7. Now IOTA is relatively cheaper, so it is a little bit less than 13 cents. So we see that it's trading on the at the level. Let me show you that according to CoinGecko, it's trading at the level of 12 cents, 0.96, so a little bit less than 13 cents, significantly lower if compared to its all-time high. But now let's start from the monthly time frame and let's have a look at the candlestick. So we have to some extent very similar price dynamics or candlesticks formations if compared to the rest of the major cryptocurrencies. For example, we know that the price of the major cryptocurrencies, they dropped in the last months of 2019. Then we had some kind of stabilization at the end of December. Later in January, most of the cryptocurrencies, they formed such kind of bullish engulfings in their price charts, including IOTA. So this is the bullish engulfing here. Then followed in February by a shooting star. So a trend reversal or a bearish candlestick indicating trend reversal of the uptrend, and now it is followed this shooting star by another bearish candlestick that has significantly big lower wick or lower shadow. But it is because it seems that the price of IOTA is receiving some kind of support. We will check it and we will see it on the shorter time frames. But on the monthly time frame, I want to outline that in my view, we have some kind of bearish signals dominating over the bullish ones. That's why I will be very careful. And just in case, I would like to remind you that if we switch to the weekly chart, this is one of the lowest levels of the price of IOTA. And even if we switch to the linear chart, this is, let's say, an all-time low. So the current level is the all-time low. So this is the current level. But I want to tell you that according to some resources, there was an over the counter trading back in 2016. So it's quite possible that at that time we had lower levels, but they are not in the price chart because it was over-the-counter market. And that's why I will say that according to the period when IOTA was heavily traded, or when there has been enough liquidity, I think that it means that this is a kind of all-time low. Just a second, fellas. Let me take the chart of IOTA once again. So I will take from Binance the first one. So this is the price chart. Now let's switch to the candlesticks chart, and I want to say that we had this reprice rebound that was and it formed this sequence of mainly bullish candlesticks with ascending local lows and ascending local highs at the very beginning of the year, or actually in the month of January. Then in the month of February, the trend reversal started, and since then we've had this sequence of mainly bearish candlesticks with descending local highs and descending local lows. But at the moment, we're at the end of the current week, so today is Sunday. We see that the current local low is higher than the previous one, but the current local high is lower than the previous one. It is similar to the situation of the cryptocurrency Cardano that I analyzed yesterday. So what I want to say is this is a kind of a period of, let's say, consensus between the bears and the bulls, but it may turn out that it's just a break before the renewal of the bearish sentiment that is easily visible on the weekly chart. That's why I will be very careful, and we need some confirmation if we think that this is the beginning of the price rebound. At the moment, once again, I think that the bullish signals dominate over the existence of the bearish ones. And if we switch to the daily chart, I just want to remind you that at the very beginning, I mentioned that this is a kind of all-time low, but it seems that the price is trying to rebound up to the level of the last local low, and it serves as a kind of magnet, and it attracts the price to that range. But it will be really very negative if after this test of the levels or of the range of the previous local low, if another bearish sentiment starts and push the price down, it will be a very bearish signal, and we have to be really very careful in this case. And what I want to say is that, yes, I have analyzed recently many price charts, and it seems that on the daily time frame, we may witness some kind of a beginning of a broad range, and it may turn out that this is a local low, relatively lower than the previous ones, but still within this new broad range. But this is just the most positive scenario at the moment. We have to keep in mind that we still have this continuation of the sequence of descending local highs and descending local lows on the daily time frame, and it means that the price is in a bearish chart or in a bearish or in a bear trend. So even on the daily time frame, I just want to outline that we have some bearish signals, and we have to be very careful. Of course, the price chart is trying to bounce off the lower line of the descending channel, but it's not a signal to jump in and to open a long position, because once again, it, just in my view, we're still in this descending channel, and of course we may change a little bit the trajectory of the upper line, but this is a descending channel. And the last thing I will continue to monitor, and I want to the last thing I want to mention today that I will continue to monitor, is the downtrend on the shorter time frames. And this is a downtrend that is easily visible on the hour, on the 1 hour time frame. Yes, the price of IOTA is testing the upper line, is hovering near the upper line of this descending channel, but it is still not trying to break out, to break through this upper line. Let's hope that the price will break through this upper line, and we will. It will be nice if we witness some kind of price rebound from the lower line up to the upper line of the descending channel. But at the moment, we're still in all those bearish or downtrends in the different time frames. That's why, at the moment, in my view, it is a clear signal that we have to be very careful, because the bears still control the market. That's it for today, fellas, about the price chart of IOTA. I just want to let you know that they have a very nice site, iota.org. You can check their white paper, for example, and all the information about this cryptocurrency. Unfortunately, I want to say that sometimes I follow their announcements, their blog, and I don't see a lot of activity, to be honest, in their ecosystem. I mean activity that will be able to contribute to the successful implementation of IOTA in the cryptocurrency world. Of course, they publish sometimes interesting information, but it seems that IOTA still cannot attract a lot of attention to its technology, and probably it means that the cryptocurrency community still doesn't consider IOTA as the solution to the scalability issue of Bitcoin and the other cryptocurrencies that use blockchain technology. So that's it for today, fellas. Please share your view about IOTA, about the price chart of IOTA and this cryptocurrency. I will be very glad to hear your point of view. Of course, I wish you a wonderful day and hope to see you in the next video. It was me again at CryptoSpa. I'm on Hive Blockchain and I will continue to be on Steam Blockchain as well. Thank you for watching.